Right now, trillions of bacteria are nestled comfortably in the home of your body. They're in your gut, doing things like digesting your food and orchestrating your mood. They're on your skin, educating your immune system on potential invaders and giving your cheeks a radiant glow. Quite literally, they're everywhere. And without them, you'd be in pretty bad shape. While you'd likely be able to survive, you wouldn't be very happy. On this show, we're diving deep into all things microbiome. Most people are familiar with the gut microbiome, but do you really know what it takes to keep your microbial colonies healthy, happy, and playing nice with the inner reaches of you? On each episode, we'll take a look at how different people and companies are moving the microbiome field forward. Through interviews with leading researchers, we'll look at how exercise, stress, diet, hygiene, and more move us closer to microbial synergy, or farther away. We'll peek inside the guts and habits of everyday people so that we can start to understand how the actions we take impact the bugs of our body. We'll also chat with the entrepreneurs who are pioneering the probiotic foods and beverages we're seeing on grocery store shelves. I'm your host, Andrea Wien, and this is the Microbiome Report, powered by Biome Health, a podcast dedicated to the microscopic stuff that makes our world hugely interesting. Today, to kick things off, we've got Afif Ghanoum in the studio to shed some light on what you can look forward to in upcoming episodes of the show. Afif is the CEO of Biome, a company that maps the microbiome and provides customized recommendations on how you can better balance your microbiome. He's also the son of Dr. Mahmoud Ghanoum, the director of the Center for Medical Mycology at Case Western Reserve University. Dr. Ghanoum has researched the microbiome for 40 years and was the first scientist to coin the term mycobiome for the fungal communities that coexist with their more well-known bacterial cousins. So, without further ado, let's hear from Afif. Afif, thank you so much for coming on the show.
Thanks for having me.
So tell us a little bit about why you wanted to start this podcast.
So it kind of relates to everything I've done working with my father, right? So he's literally the scientist that named microbiome. He's, since I was a little kid, been funded by the government to research medically important bacteria, medically important fungi in particular, and even biofilms. But what I realized when I worked as a corporate lawyer was that it's very difficult sometimes to take this ivory tower research and make it relatable to everyday people. And so our first step in doing that was actually bringing that science into the consumer world. And then in the podcast, what I noticed was that there's a giant echo chamber of people talking about the microbiome and gut health, but they really have no expertise to be doing so other than general, yeah, gut health this, and maybe they're kind of parroting the things they've read about the microbiome, right? Like one of the my favorite things, you see it all the time repeated is, oh, we have 10 times the microbial cells compared to human cells. And that's just not accurate, right? It's more like we have 30 trillion human cells and we have about 39 trillion microbial cells. So even that, these mythologies just start to get built up and repeated. So there's a lot, and obviously in the wellness space, there's a ton of media, there's a lot of excitement. And then while there's a lot of excitement and interest in digestive health, to me, there was a real gap in informed but relatable information about the microbiome. So, you know, as I said to you off air, to me, it's almost like taking a Freakonomics approach to the microbiome, because what's so exciting is if you look at the microbiome, it's like cancer was 60 years ago, where it used to be to our grandparents when their grandparents died, oh, they died of old age. No, the reality is a lot of people died of cancer, other health issues that we only started to really realize were health conditions. But guess what? Over the last 60 years, we're still figuring out how to combat cancer. But over the decades and decades, we've learned a lot. With the microbiome, we're like 10 years into it, where we've realized that it's this important community. It's not all bad organisms. In fact, everybody used to think of germs as just bad. We got to get rid of them. Out of the trillions and trillions and thousands of different, you know, phenotypes and really existing microorganisms, there's like 100 that are actually pathogenic and bad for you, right? So we've just started to realize and go from this consciousness of the microbiome is something we need to be aware of to now you're seeing every day correlations being built between the microbiome and everything from obviously gut health, but even to brain health and mood and everything in between. The problem is it's very hard to know what to do with all that information. Is it actionable? What does it actually mean? For me, also, it's a lot of cleaning up a lot of disinformation and misinformation that's out there, right?
A lot of fake news.
Literally fake news in the gut, and it's sad. No, I'm just kidding. But really, so to me, the goal with this is to create an easy-to-understand, accessible information source on what we need to know about the microbiome and what you can do to optimize the microbiome. Because at the end of the day, that's really the goal.
Yeah, and I think having the people who are doing the research, so it's coming straight from the lab versus coming down the chain, like you said, where so many people are just regurgitating the information and we're seeing the same conversation being had over and over and over, is so important. So I'm very excited to have the top researchers and top scientists who are really looking at these problems in on the show, talking to us. How have you seen the public acceptance of the microbiome change, or even awareness? I think even still, I talk to people that have no idea that we have different microbiomes, what the microbiome is. So coming from your knowledge base of having this inherent information for so long in your life, how has it been a little surreal to see now it coming into the mainstream?
Yeah, even when we created Biome off of my father's research on the microbiome and Crohn's, that was like under 3 years ago, the microbiome is a term outside either hyper-informed consumers or obviously scientists. Basically, it didn't exist, right? Barely the idea that there's like good bacteria, like everybody's used to growing up with Jamie Lee Curtis and Activia ads. Like that, you know, over the last decade, people started to buy into that, right? But they didn't really know why. Now, even in 2 years, it's like computers where information gets so obsolete so fast, but people are very much aware. But what's not there is being able to understand that while you know it's important, what is actually good information and actionable, and what is a lot of hype, but it's you know, the horse is leading the cart on the science. And that's what I, you know, going back to what you said, one of the things I think the goal with what we're doing is to make it very accessible information, right? Like, you know, I remember we were talking to a researcher who had done really interesting research on people in the ER after a bad accident, that their microbiome would change. And so after about 40 minutes of talking to him, what we sussed out was that inflammation, because their body had just been through crazy trauma, inflammation was really having a big impact on their microbiome. So it went from this, like, let's talk to this guy, it's interesting, but wow, that's like pretty niche, like people, bad accidents, ER, to, wow, this is really about inflammation, and that, you know, this was a microcosm of inflammation's role in the gut, right? Mm-hmm. So to me, that's the exciting thing about it.
Yeah, I think too, I mean, our microbiome is changing all the time. For example, in pregnancy, we see that certain bacteria take over because maybe the mom's immune system is a little lower because the baby is taking some of these things. So I think what we're really trying to explore here is how our microbiome changes on a day-to-day basis based on the inputs and outputs that we have going on. So excited to be doing this show, and thank you so much for coming on and giving us a little insight.
Super excited about it, and thanks for having me.
If you like what you've heard and you're excited to hear more, please subscribe to the Microbiome Report wherever you get your podcasts. We'll see you soon.